Hey, are you looking for information on how to use Lightroom? I'm about to show you how to do a basic edit, so don't go away. Hi there, Barry Callister for Barry Callister Photography, giving you hints, tips, and tricks for better nature photography. Welcome to my channel, I'm glad you found me. This is the place where I do gear reviews, camera tutorials, Lightroom and Photoshop tutorials, and so much more. So if you're new here, please hit that subscribe button. Now, it's been a while since I did a Lightroom tutorial, so I thought I'd take you through just a basic edit that I will do on an image I'm going to upload to Facebook or Instagram or somewhere like that. So this is the base, just a starting point that I'll use, and I'll move on from there if the image needs something more. So let's get right into it. Make sure you hang around to the end of the video because I'm going to give you three awesome keyboard shortcuts that are going to make your workflow so much faster. So let's jump into this basic edit in Lightroom. Go! All right, so we're starting here in the library module. I'm gonna edit this photo here of these rocks for this tutorial. So we'll just click develop to open that up in the develop module. Now, the first thing I will do is come over to the right-hand side here and click on lens corrections and make sure that both of those are clicked. I normally apply lens corrections on import, but sometimes earlier on in Lightroom I didn't do that, so I always check that that is done. If you want to know how to apply a preset on import in Lightroom, I have a video about that. I've linked that up in the right hand corner of the screen now, so go there if you want to, but we'll just have a look here. I'll show you whereabouts you find that. So you click on file, import photos and video. If you go over here to apply during import, your lens corrections, that's how I've got it set up in there, is for lens corrections to be applied during import. So watch that video to learn how to do that. The next thing I will do is come down to camera calibration. It'll be Adobe Standard by default. So I click on that generally and I will select camera standard. That looks good for this image. If it doesn't look good, just choose another option. This is all about what looks good really for this. So I don't play with any of those other sliders there because this is just a basic edit, so we want to stick to the basics. Then I'll go up to my basic panel, and you want to watch your histogram here. If you're not using your histogram in Lightroom or on your camera, you really should be. Your histogram gives you a true picture of the exposure of your image. You can't trust your eyes because your monitor and your LCD screen on your camera will lie to you, because different lighting conditions will make images look brighter or darker than they actually are. The histogram gives you a true representation of the exposure of your image. So if you use your mouse here and you hover over the histogram, you can see on the right hand side is the whites, then you've got your highlights in that section, the midsection is your exposure or your midtones, shadows and blacks over on the left hand side. And you can see these two arrows here, this is your shadow clipping and this is your highlight clipping. If you've overexposed or underexposed any part of your photograph, those will be lit up. So I'll just quickly, if I crank the highlights up here and just crank up the exposure, you'll see now there, this is showing me that I've clipped those areas, and those areas are now overexposed and there's no detail in there. So you want to watch that. If you need more information about how to use a histogram, there's loads of videos on YouTube. Check out those, or I'm going to do one soon, so watch out for that. So the next thing I will do, because this image looks to be pretty well exposed, I will go down to my white values. This is to set the white point. If you move your mouse over the numerical value there on the white slider, hold Alt and click your mouse and drag to the right until you see some dots come in. Now you want to make sure you back it off then until there are no overexposed or clipped parts there. So that seems to be at about 59. So I'll leave that there. Then you want to do the same with your black slider. Hold Alt, click the numbers, and then drag it down until you see some blacks come in. That's about there. that's good. If you want to at any stage see the results of your edit, you can click your backslash key for the before view and then the after. So you can see just from doing that alone, this image is just popped now. There's a lot more color in it. There's a lot more contrast. It's really quite good. Now this does show that we're clipping the blacks here, and if I just tell Lightroom to show that to me by clicking that arrow there, you can see that's in these dark sections, these shadowy sections, which I'm not really too concerned about because we don't really need detail in there at all, so I'm not going to worry about that. The next thing I will do is play around with my shadows and highlight sliders if I want to bring up the shadows a bit more, which I'm really not too concerned about with this image. I want it to be a bit gritty and grainy, kind of have a very contrasty look, so I'm not gonna, and the highlights I'm probably gonna leave alone there too. The next thing that I will do is I will maybe play with the contrast slider and see if it looks good with a bit more contrast or a bit less. Now, a lot of the time when you're doing this, you want to sort of take it to the point where it looks overdone and then back it off, because you'll always overdo it pretty much. And seeing over edited images on Facebook or Instagram is never fun for me. So take it to where you think it looks great and then back it off a little bit. I'm going to leave the contrast at about 26 there. I think that looks good. And if you want to see the results of the before and after of the step that you just did, just go over here to your history panel and click back before your contrast. So this is before my contrast, this is after. So that's added a bit of pop there. I kind of like that. I'll then come down to the clarity slider. Maybe you add a bit of clarity. Now you can see there, that is way too much. If that was the look I was going for, awesome, but it's not. So I'm gonna back that right off to about, we'll say 17 looks good. Just check it before that and after. So you can see it's given this rock here a lot more detail and grittiness. I kind of like that. I rarely play with my vibrance or saturation sliders unless I really, really want the image to pop a lot more. I don't like what it does to the image. It makes it look unnatural and not quite real. So I might up that about 7. Saturation again is a slider you have to be really careful with. Don't overdo it. You know, I rarely use a value above 7 with saturation. Just have a look what that looks before, after. That's given it a nice bit of color there. Now, on rare occasions, I will play with the tone curve. I don't use it an awful lot, but let's have a look today and we'll see what we can do. The highlights, I might bring that up a little bit just to give it a bit of brightness there. The lights we'll play with a little bit there. You can do this by clicking and dragging the graph here, but I don't do that. I'm not gonna do that today anyway. The lights up there, the darks, not really liking what that's doing. Shadows, not liking what that's doing either. The darks maybe down a little bit there. And you can always click this switch here on the left-hand side of the panel. That'll turn off that particular effect. And you can see the results of it there too, so that looks kind of good. Let's have backslash keys there, what it was like before and now. Looking fairly good. I'm not going to play with the HSL sliders at all. That's your color. I'm not going to do split toning, but I will do detail. Now, if you want to, you normally want to set this for a section of your image that is in focus, first of all, and has a bit of grain to it. So like this rock up here, perhaps, might be a good idea. So I'll hit this little crosshairs thing here and that's not really in focus. Let's choose another bit here. Maybe this bit like here will be good. That's got a nice defined edge in that hole in the rock there. It'll be good for our sharpening and stuff. So with sharpening, I'll generally set the radius to 1.4. And then what you can do with the masking slider here is hold Alt and click the slider, drag it across, and you'll see parts of it are turning black. Anything that's white, the sharpening will be applied to. Anything that's black will not be sharpened. So I don't really want to sharpen these areas in here between the rocks. So we'll just keep that up to about there, that's good. And then you can watch your little thumbnail here and crank up your sharpening. It's always a good idea as well to have your image at 1:1 to do this, and have it on the same area sort of as your thumbnail over here, so you can see if you're starting to get artifacts or any amount of noise. See there, I've overdone it, so you don't want to go there. I am guilty of over sharpening my images a lot, so I think about 30 on this is good. So I'll turn that off and see what it's done. That's very subtle. I might bump it up about more than 45 there. That's good. Now that has created also a lot of noise as well, so we'll grab the luminance slider here in our noise reduction and pump that up there a little bit. There's a bit of color noise I'm seeing in there too. Your color noise is very visible if you go up to about 4:1 or 8:1 or anything higher than that. So you can see if I grab my color noise slider here and I back it right off, you can see all these blues and purples and stuff and yellows and greens coming in here. So you just want to dial that up until that all goes away. You can double click it to reset it back to the default value there too. So that's kind of good. Just look at it before and after again. That's looking pretty good. So I think we're all good. Now that's pretty much all I will do to an image. Generally, occasionally I'll use the effects panel to apply a vignette just to the corners, but with this image, I don't really think we need it. So you can see there, if you slide to the left, you get black edges coming in on your photo. You slide to the right, you'll get white edges, your white vignette. I always like a black vignette. I'm not too fond of white ones. So that does look kind of good. If I was trying to bring people's attention to these rocks here, to these two big rocks, or these rocks in the center, this group of four here, I would probably apply a vignette, but I'm not in this particular occasion, so I won't use a vignette. And that is pretty much it for what I do for a basic edit. That is where I'll leave it. You can see the before and after here, like so. It's really popping now. That's got a lot of color, it's got vibrance, it's got contrast, it's just a much better image, and it's gonna look so much better on a cushion. So now we come to the three keyboard shortcuts that I promised you. The first one of which is to first of all bring your image in from the library module. So let's say we're in the library module here and you wanted to edit this image. You click D on your keyboard, that'll shoot you straight into the develop module real fast, and you can start editing your image. While you're in the develop module, if you want to see your before and after, not just like we were doing with the backslash key, but side by side, hit the Y key, and you can see there it'll give you a before and after side by side view of what your image is looking like. And if you hit Y again, it takes you back to full view there. And this last keyboard shortcut, super exciting. This is really good. A lot of the time you want to zoom in 1:1 to your image to check focus or look for dust spots on your sensor or things like that. Now what you can do is click and hold the space bar and you'll see your cursor changes into a hand symbol, and you can then click and drag and look around your image at 1:1. Now this is working at 1:1 here because I had 1:1 selected last time. If I'd done 4:1, it would take me back to 4:1. So you want to choose 1:1 there, and it's excellent. Hitting the space bar, and you can let go of the space bar and just move around there with your hand tool, and it's just fantastic. And you can check your image out at 1:1 and hit the space bar again, and you're back to full view there. Excellent.
There you have it.
That is your basic edit in Lightroom. If you have any questions for me about anything you saw me do in the video today, please pop them in the comments below. I'll be glad to answer your questions. Make sure before you leave, you hit that like button and smash that subscribe button. I'm Barry Callister for Barry Callister Photography. Get out there, take some wicked shots, and I will see you soon.